and they're ready. Hits the button, off and racing, last of them away, just Adora Bell, Shuey from the inside, won the start from Rocket Juice, Classic Ruler, and also up there soon after the start, Mine Host. In behind those, next of all, I'm Napoti pushing through from Bergamo, and then came Crimo. A little worse than midfield when they get going into stride, being followed then over on the outside by Tiger Line. Over on the rails then, just Adora Bell, and then Hubert back with those, and around them, four and five wide is Uncle Gerard. Out in the middle of the course as they work down the side. 750 to go, and Shuey leads the way by three quarters. Running second, Classic Ruler, back on the inside to Rocket Juice in a commanding spot. Running fourth next of all is Mine Host, being followed by Crimo. Uncle Gerard is right off the course, and he's been no better than four and five wide throughout, trailed by Hubert. Over on the inside, just Adora Bell back with Bergamo. Near the tail end of the field on straightening for home by the 300, and Shuey leads the way. Rocket Juice looking for a run on the inside, and Classic Ruler just battling. Shuey is still in front from Rocket Juice. Classic Ruler, Uncle Gerard keeps on coming down the outside. It's still Shuey with 100 left to go. Shuey holding on from Classic Ruler, just Adora Bell. Bergamo getting through, but Shuey's going to hold on. Shuey just won from the fast finishing Bergamo. Not sure about third though, Classic Ruler or Rocket Juice from a gallant Uncle Gerard. He had covered some ground, and I'm Napoti, followed deeper out by Hubert. Not far from those behind them, pulling up next, just Adora Bell. Crimo, followed further back by Mine Host, who's amongst the last of them to greet the judge, and back with it is Tiger Line. Shuey, the horse with an unusual way to say its name, wins it. First up for Jimmy Taylor, ridden by a Braden Garth. Whatever way you want to say it, Shuey leads all the way and gets the job done here in the Schweppes Handicap. Over number 10, second, Bergamo slicing and dicing away through for Clint Johnston Porter. Rocket Juice holds third from Classic Ruler. The interim placings 5, 10, 1, 2 after the running of race 6. The Schweppes Handicap by Jimmy Chu from Three Way Girl for Alan Beer at McAllister, Mrs. K. Wardle, and ridden by a Braden Garth. It's the second win in Shuey's career. Good effort by Bergamo first up as well, charging to the line after getting through the opening between Classic Ruler and Shuey by Caravaggio out of Admiring for Carolyn Grant. Trained by Grant and Delana Williams, Clint Johnston Porter. Rocket Juice third by Bondi from Juice for Colin Loxton, trained by Neville Parnham and ridden by Luke Campbell. Time for the race, 120-10-35-65. The last 600, winning margin a short neck by three quarters. Does it all the way, Shuey, but a good run by Bergamo there. The way that she hit the line strongly late indicates that she might be set for a pretty reasonable preparation as well. Next event today, 1,200 of the Tab Touch. Have you got the Touch Handicap at 3.13? 10 running, no changes. Let's go downstairs. And after this victory of Shuey, we'll take you to Lockie Taylor there, who'll no doubt be pretty pleased about the outcome of that race.
Thanks, Darren. And now joined by Dad, Jim Taylor. Dad, this horse is fairly unassuming, but he is extremely tough, and that was on display again today.
Yeah, well, as you give the instructions before the race and told Braden, just keep the foot down all the way and try and slip him on the corner, and worked well.
In the end, he looks fairly one-paced in the finish. Is he the type of horse that you expect to get out over a little bit further this time in?
Oh, that's probably about his distance. 13, 1400 is probably ideal for him. He just bowls all the way. So, yeah, probably only up to 14, I'd say.
What did you make of his last campaign? He was the beaten favourite on one or two occasions, but did he just not come up? Was there anything behind the scenes that suggested to you or the stable that he wasn't right?
I think, as you know, that first up run we got taken on by a young apprentice in front, and he had a gut buster, and after that he didn't come up after running a brilliant race. The horse that took him on finished 100 yards away, and it's not ideal first up to have a run like that, and today he got his own way in front.
And always nice to train a winner in those colours. Those colours have been pretty successful for you.
Yeah, Alan McAllister, back to the Magnificio days. It's good, very good people, the McAllisters.
Well done here.
Thanks.
There's Jim Taylor, Dad, the old man, and here's Braden Garth riding for him.
He is riding in very good form, especially on these front runners. Braden, today it looked like you were able to pinch a couple of cheap sectionals and then get them chasing when you wanted to.
Yeah, it worked out perfect today. Obviously very well placed, barrier one. We're able to get it easy throughout and then just slowly quicken from the 600.
He has been a horse that has been a little bit scratchy out of the machine from time to time, but it looked like he jumped very cleanly today.
Yeah, he was very good today, probably the best he's been. So, yeah, very happy with that.
At what stage did you start to grow in confidence?
I was actually pretty confident all the way. He sort of, he just got into a nice rhythm and he was giving me a beautiful feel. Then when we straightened, he quick and lovely, and I knew we had him, put him to bed.
West Speed Final on the weekend's worth $100,000 in your eye one for Adam Durant. Some sort, that looks a special sort, I should say. Looks a lovely race for him.
Yeah, very well placed. Barrier two, I think we'll get a beautiful run from there and he should be primed and ready to go.
Congratulations, well done.
Thank you very much.
There's Braden Garth continuing his good form in the saddle. He combines with Jim Taylor and Shuey to take out the Schweppes Handicap. We'll be right back.